I was also sent this over the break. I found this absolutely fascinating. It's from Prison Movement. Tens of thousands of U.S. inmates are being paid pennies to minimum wage, minus fines and victim compensation, for everything from grunt work to firefighting to specialized labor. Now, as you know, we've covered on the show before how there's a rapid amount of people who are being placed in prison. States are promising prison operators that they will keep the prison system 90% full. And a lot of us who haven't been to prison think, well, what kind of work are they doing? Are you talking about where they get 20 cents an hour for sweeping the hallways if they're not a threat to others? Are you talking about how they stamp license plates for the state? That's awesome, Josh. Why would you not like that? It saves us money out of the state budget. No, that's not what I'm talking about. Get this. This will just blow your mind. Each month, California inmates process more than 680,000 pounds of beef, 400,000 pounds of chicken products, 450 gallons of milk, 280,000 loaves of bread, 2.9 million eggs. Yeah, for companies like Starbucks. They package gaming systems for Nintendo. They do work for JCPenney, for Victoria's Secret, Walmart. I'm not kidding. So here we have the situation where not only do we have a growing inmate population, but that inmate population is being abused. I mean, what's the difference? Honestly, what's the difference between this and indentured servitude or even slavery? Because they're getting paid 20 cents an hour. 20 cents an hour. Now, I am completely for sweeping the hallway for 20 cents an hour and emptying the trash cans. If you're an inmate, absolutely. Because it saves you and I money. You did something bad against society. There's no reason society should have to pay you a huge wage. But I am against the states working in conjunction with private corporations, large corporations, by the way, and those corporations getting the benefit of essentially slave labor. Because not only is it abusive to the prisoners, and I don't care what they're in there for. I don't care. Well, Josh, he robbed a bank. I don't care. We don't become worse than the people who we lock up. So not only is that aspect of this absolutely deplorable, but we also have the aspect that these large corporations are getting labor cheap. And let's just look at the reality of that. You have mom-and-pop businesses. 53% of small businesses, according to a recent survey, cannot sustain themselves. They need another source of income just to keep the business open. Another 30% don't have the financial momentum to carry them 10 years. So 8 out of 10 small businesses out there need help. Yet at the same time, they have to pay minimum wage. They have to pay, you know, higher wages for skilled workers. But these larger corporations, no. And then you wonder why. You wonder why these large corporations are also for, oh yeah, raise the minimum wage. Yeah, we'll give to that candidate. Go for it. Raise it through the roof. We don't care. Hey, should be $26 an hour anyway. You know why these large corporations don't care? Because they're not hiring those people. They're hiring the people in prison at 20 cents an hour. That makes prison labor cheaper than labor in China, in Indonesia, the sweatshops of Asia. Well, Josh, it gives them something to do. Don't give me that. One prison system is raising over 160,000 hens, so they have eggs. Now, do those inmates get the benefit of that production? No, they don't. And it doesn't even go to the victims. It's not like they're making $50 an hour and the victim of the burglary is getting $49 an hour until it gets paid off. No, that's not the case at all. 20 cents an hour is it. That's what they're making. And this isn't new. It's been going on for a long time. Just most of us have no clue that it's happening. Matter of fact, here's part of the article. A stitch in time. California's inmates sew their own garb. Subcontractor, third generation, hires inmates in South Carolina to sew lingerie and leisure wear for Victoria's Secrets and JCPenney's. In 1997, a California prison put two men in solitary for telling journalists they were ordered to replace Made in Honduras labels on garments with Made in the USA. So here we have a system that not only is it abusive, but the system is aware of its abuse and they're trying to cover it up. They're trying to cover it up. So garments will come in from another country. Oh, no, we got to change that. Say Made in the USA. And when you get something that says Made in the USA, makes you wonder, doesn't it? Here's another one. A California prison dental laboratory, inmates produce a complete set of dentures, bite blocks, tray-ins, and custom trays. You wonder why you can't succeed in a small business? Because corporations have 20 cents an hour labor brought to you by your local law enforcement. Unbelievable. We'll be back right after this. You know, I'm going to make a bold statement, but it's absolutely true. So don't let the shock value of the statement take away from the truth of it. This is not a shock jock sort of program. I don't scream in the microphone. I don't get sensational. But the realization of what we were just talking about is immense. It's immense. And the statement is, the United States government owns slaves. I kid you not. Think about this for a second. Just think this out. I know, completely alarming to actually think that that's a possibility. But what are we looking at? We're looking at a situation when over 1% of this population, matter of fact, according to 2008 numbers, over one in every 100 adults were incarcerated. So over 1%. In 2008, get this, in 2008, one in every 31 adults in the United States was either behind bars or being monitored either through probation or parole. We have an alarming increase in the number of felony charges every single year. There's almost 2.5 million people in the federal prison system or in the total prison system, whether it's federal, county, state, whatever. And that's not including local jails or military jails. Tribal jails. We have almost 100,000 people in juvenile jail. So just in the federal system. And what do we see happening with them? As that last article pointed out, they're conducting labor on behalf of corporations at 20 cents an hour. Now you might be thinking, well, Josh, then that's not slavery. I mean, slaves don't get paid. No, actually, a lot of them did. And a lot of people don't realize this. Yes, they were slaves. And they would be whipped and beaten and all that sort of stuff. Terrible, terrible, terrible. But they were also, in many, many, many cases, they were also allowed to earn a little bit of income. Not much. I'm not saying that they could have a house, and that's not what I'm saying at all. But there were situations where if they were gardening for the household and they had extra produce, the slave owners would often allow them to sell that extra produce and keep whatever it is they had. It would just, you know, a little money for them or whatever. A lot of slave owners also paid a little bit of money for overtime. Now, I get it that it's a little bit of money. But how is that different than what we're paying the inmates? We're paying them 20 cents an hour. 20 cents an hour. And the beneficiaries of that labor are corporations. And the state is in bed with the corporations to the tune of promising contractually. There are contracts between private prison operators and states that the state will keep the prison 90% full. Why do you think there are so many laws that can make you guilty? Every single one of us, on average, will commit some sort of felony this week. And that's not an exaggeration. But there's so many laws, over 2.1 million laws, rules, regulations, ordinances, codes. And what else do slaves and this modern day incarceration phenomenon have in common? Well, slaves weren't allowed to vote. Neither are felons. Slaves weren't allowed to own firearms. Neither are felons. How is this different? I understand it's shocking. I get it. But think about the magnitude of this. 93% of the inmates in jail are male. And they're performing labor for the benefit of corporations that are making a profit. And they have no option. They can't opt out. They are stuck there. How is this not modern-day slavery? And it's at the hands of our government. And worst of all, it's funded by you and I. Let's go to Steve in Illinois. Steve, welcome to the show, sir.
On your subject on prisons here, of course, in this little locale where I'm at, I watch and look at the court dispositions. And people that commit, no wonder crime's down in this country, as they say, because everything just about gets dismissed. I mean, violent crimes and everything. But one after the other, they get picked up on the highway here. We're like a drug interception place around here or something. And they pull them over. At one time, they pulled a car over because the guy was doing right at 65 mile per hour. And the state police thought that was, wow, unusual. So they pulled him over. Yes. And actually he had pot in that. But the pot traffickers, so-called, and that are getting 12 flat years for doing it. And it doesn't have to be real large amounts in that they catch them with. They are just hammering them for a pot, and all these violent crimes are going by the wayside. And see, apparently pot travelers and that must be good workers. They must really fit in.
Well,
but I can't, in 12 years.
Well, and to add to that, Steve, they know the attrition rate so high that even if they get out in 4 or 5, they know they're going to have that labor back. They know the labor's coming back in under 2 years, usually. So you have a situation where you're absolutely right. Police are getting completely out of control. And yes, people are being pulled over, arrested, ticketed for being innocent. They're sent to these slave camps where they perform work for 20 cents an hour. Most of the drug charges are really just a labor force procurement system.
That's right.
And then they're released and then recharged less than 2 years later.
You know, Josh, I want to say, too, far be it from me to, you know, stand up for the police and that, but I have to believe, you know, you've been bringing up different things and that, and it kind of broad brushes it a little bit, but because you got to stop and think. Thank God what you're bringing up is looked at upon as an anomaly. That's why it's hitting the news. So I hope it's, you know, it isn't the rule, but more the exception. And I have to say, our police officers and that are, I don't know, I don't run into a lot of what you're saying in that, you know, but thank God.
Well, actually, Steve, yes, you do. Yes, you do, and I'll tell you why. Not all of them are pulling over the grandma, she has a constitution, so let's taser them. But all of them, well, there might be some exceptions, but the vast, vast, vast majority of them do ticket you for not wearing your seatbelt. Well, that's not constitutional. A lot of them do set up speed traps just to generate revenue. Well, that's not constitutional. So whether it's the actual abuse or it's just using the people as livestock to fleece when they want additional revenue, it's not an exception. It's not an anomaly. And even when we look at the abusive cases, those are becoming so prevalent where law enforcement as an entity is the largest gang we have. They're responsible for more murders, more rapes, more sexual assaults, more theft, more allegations. And if any other organization acted like this, it would be shut down immediately. If one in every 1,000 employees for United Airlines raped a woman on an airplane, United Airlines would be shut down by noon tomorrow.
Sure. But don't you think we should lay a lot of blame at the politicians? They're just carrying out what the politicians are passing, and they're stupid, of course. I mean, you know, they make you do things in a so-called free society. I think the police are kind of got their hands tied on some of this, except for the violent stuff, and everyone stand around that. You're going to be ostracized and probably gotten out of the police force if you did try to stand up. I just think there's enough blame to go around for a lot of entities here. But yeah.
Absolutely.
And I just think the politicians are the ones we should be after. Hey, I enjoy your show, and I thank you for the time.
Thank you, Steve. Well, it's kind of like the mafia. You know, you have the wise guy, the hitman out there, and yes, he's to blame. He actually pulled the trigger, but you also have, you know, Don Corleone back in the at the family wedding, and he's to blame too. It's a complete system. We have judges that are on the same side as the state. Isn't it odd that the state versus you and the state is the judge? I mean, the system right there is stacked against you. So it's the state versus Steve. And the judge, which is an employee of the state, gets to decide. Oh, and by the way, remember, judge, we have to keep the percent or the prisons 90% full. Contractually, we have to. Well, wouldn't you know it? Yeah, we're going to have to sentence you to 24 months. Oh, and by the way, make sure those Walmart products are billed for us at 20 cents an hour. We'll be back right after this.